And then 1933 was another eventful day, time, because that was when the Century of Progress was on in Chicago. And my cousin and I got a job for the summer at the Japanese Pavilion. And that was the exhibit put on by the Japanese government. And it was a lovely tea house, you know, and they served. And that's where they introduced this green tea drink. And they put the powdered green tea that you use for the tea ceremony. They took a couple spoonful of that, added just a little bit of sugar with lemon, and they shook it up with water, and they served it with a maraschino cherry. And that became a very, very popular drink that featured at this Japanese Pavilion, you know. And then not only the Pavilion had all kinds of exhibits of silk making, art and craft work, and oh, different phases. It was all on exhibit. And our job was to stand and explain and introduce them. So we spent the summer, that summer of 33, working, which made it possible for me to stay on and study for another year or two. So that's how I got my education in Chicago, which was very unexpected.
Well, let me ask you, it must have been quite unusual at that time for you as a Japanese-American Nisei woman. There must have been very few of you in Chicago at that time.
Well, there were some. There was evidently enough. I have some pictures of it. And on the opening night, we were all dressed in Japanese kimono and helped usher. And then another high point at the fair was the opening concert of 5,000 voices with, I think, 200 members of the Chicago Symphony accompanied them. And George L. Tenney, our leader, choir director, was directing Handel's Messiah. And in the open air, at one end, the Soldier's Field, and that was an experience. And my cousin and I were the only two Japanese participating in this mass of 5,000 voices, and sky was the limit, and it was really something that I'll never forget. It's very vivid in my mind.
It sounds to me that would also be quite unusual for Issei parents to allow their daughter to go so far
away.
Yes.
See, we were sent for just this 2 weeks conference, and then to turn out to be 3 years, you know. And then for things to develop like that, it just seemed unbelievable. You know? And my life in 3 years in Chicago and in the home of Dr. and Mrs. J.N. Rodehaver was something that's been very, I'm sure has had a lot to do in influencing my thinking and my future life, you know.